So as far as the subject CP5151 advanced data structure and algorithms is concerned, there are 5 units, out of which today we are going to see about the first unit. The title of the unit is Role of Algorithms in Computing. So these are the various topics under unit 1. We will be starting with algorithms and how you have to see algorithm as a technology, then how a simple algorithm can be developed for an insertion sorting problem, and how that developed algorithm can be analyzed, and how more such kind of algorithms can be designed, and with respect to algorithms, is there any mathematical function can we derive it with respect to its growth of input? Input for insertion sort set of numbers like that. With respect to the set of input, how you can calculate the growth with respect to time as well as with respect to space requirements as a mathematical functions, for which you need some notations and some standard functions. They are called by the name asymptotic notations and standard notations as well as some common functions, and how you derive those things. Is there any representation available? Yes, of course. There is a representation available. Those representation is called recurrence relation. And how you derive that recurrence relation by means of substitution method or unit 1, right? So I hope you all well received my voice. Is my voice audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, shall I proceed further like this? In general, okay. I used to give some PowerPoint presentation. Based on the material, I will prepare a brief notes about the topic in a simplified manner so that you will receive the idea in a very short time, and you can study that idea, memorize that idea, and you can reproduce the same well in the examination. Due to this pandemic lockdown period, we are forced to do conduct the classes online, as well as you are asked to discuss about the subject, take up the examination via online mode only. That is, the examination is in the form of MCQ type. You will be giving with multiple choice option questions, and you are asked to carry out the test maybe for an hour, or maybe for a very short duration and compared with a written examination, right? So in that sense, what I feel is I don't want to prepare a slide and put the only the main content in the slide. And what I expect you from us, since the question is of MCQ type, I expect you both to read the textbook completely. If and only if you read the textbook completely, you can understand the in-depth of the subject, and you are in a position to write or give answer for any type of MCQ which can taken from any part of the book. So what I feel to handle class for you is, I have ebooks with me, and I have uploaded the ebook in the Google Classroom also. You can download it, and I will go through the topic discussed in the book as per our syllabus, and accordingly you need to take the material and you need to read the textbook so that you will be in a position to understand what exactly the content is and how to prepare yourself for MCQ type of questions, right? I hope you understand. So as far as the first unit concerned, the title of the first unit is Role of Algorithms in Computing. So this is the textbook, that is Introduction to Algorithms by Thomas H. Corman. So this book I will have uploaded in the Google Classroom. You can download it. For first unit, we will use this book. And for rest of the unit, I will go through the book. If that content exactly fits in the book, we can follow that book. Otherwise, we can switch over to some other book, right? So Role of Algorithms in Computing. This first chapter, this is the foundation chapter, Role of Algorithms. This is the entire thing, probabilistic analysis. And so this 5 subsections will cover the first unit. So I will read the book. And I will highlight the important key points, and wherever you need some explanation in order to understand the concept, I will give elaborate explanation about that, right? So if you go into the topic, you all know about what is an algorithm. So if you could see that, I think the screen visible. I will little bit zoom it. Is it visible or not? See, what are the questions asked by the author of the book in the beginning of the chapter? What are algorithms? Why is the study of algorithms worthwhile? What is the role of algorithms related to other technologies used in computer? Like that, right? So what he is trying to say through his book is, you need to understand the basic definition about algorithm and why you need to write an algorithm and how the algorithm is helpful in a way like other technologies are with the computer, right? So what is an algorithm? You always heard about this because you come to a PG level. So under UG level as well as in many situations, you heard about the definition of the algorithm. So it is a well narrated step, or it is a well well planned instruction. So what is that well planned and well narrated? See, whenever a problem is given to you and you are in a position to solve the problem using computer, so what you have to do is, first of all, you should devise the procedure to solve the problem. So in order to devise the procedure to solve the problem, so what you can do is, you need to thoroughly study the problem, understand the basic fundamentals of the problem, and you have to think about what might be the input for the problem and what might be the solution that can be produced out of the problem. So in such a way, and if you're doing so, you can list down the various activity that you can do in order to tackle the problem. So the various steps are nothing but some kind of instructions that you need to follow in order to solve the problem. So that is the algorithm. That is algorithm. So why it is worthwhile to study algorithm? Because without an algorithm, you cannot use the computer to solve any problem. See, originally the purpose of computer machine is to solve any numerical calculations in a faster manner than human being. Like addition, subtraction, and all like that. Later, when the advancement in the hardware, advancement in the technology have grown up, so what they started doing is they started utilizing computer as a one which is expected to solve any problem that a human being can solve, but will take a lot of time. See, whatever the problems solved using computer, a human can also solve it. Yes, computer is the one which is invented by human being. So the problem solved by computer can be solved by human being also. But what is the thing lagging is, human is not that much fast in solving certain problems. Say, for example, if I ask you to add a 5-digit number to another 5-digit number, you will take little time. Maybe you will take 3 to 4 minutes to find the answer. But your computer will do it with a 2 to 3 seconds time. It will give the answer. Even though you solve the problem, you have a calculator, you need a calculator in order to confirm whether you test or not. So you have a strong belief that you may commit an error, but a computer won't give any false result. So that is the thing. You are saying that the study of algorithm is worthwhile. So in order to operate the computer, or in order to make the computer to be applicable for solving any real world problem, it is worthwhile to study algorithms. What is the role of algorithms related to other technologies? So let me go into this text, what the author is saying about. Let me take an example. So what is the example they are taken as? Sorting problem. You want to sort a given set of numbers. So what is provided to you? You always, before writing an algorithm, you need to have a problem and you need to understand the problem. So what is the problem here? The problem here is a sorting problem. So what is the sorting problem is all about? The sorting problem is all about, you need to provide a set of numbers that is treated as an input, and that numbers is not in a arranged fashion. So arranged fashion here I refer to, it is in increasing order. So that is, smaller number comes first, then followed by the next bigger number, followed by next bigger number, and it goes on up to the biggest number, right? So that is the problem of sorting. So what should be the output? So the answer is a smallest number like that. That is the output. So input you will be provided with a set of or a sequence of numbers in not in that is not in a proper order, but the output is it should be in a proper order. So that is the thing. And what you have to do is what you have to do is you need to devise the idea. You need to devise the idea because you know in what way you need to do such kind of operation. So you know it, right? So when you want, so you know mathematics, basic mathematics, you know when you want to say which number is greater and which number is smaller. So what you have to do is you have to do a simple comparison operator. So what comparison you will do? You will do either smaller than comparison or greater than comparison. It depends on you. So normally I will take greater than comparison. Yeah, I will take two number at a time from the set of given numbers. And if that number is greater, then the left number, lesser number will come first, and the greater number will come, hold the next place to the second number. And then you take the another two. So like that, you can devise an algorithm. You can devise a step for that. So that is not only the key procedure to solve any sorting problem. There are many other procedures are available, and all procedures objective is to arrange the sequence of n numbers. But the difference is how much time it is going to take. So with the, you can find an enormous amount number of sorting algorithms, but the difference between each and every algorithm is in terms of the time consumption with respect to finding the solution. So that is the idea here. So what kind of problems are solved? What kind of problems are the computer you can able to solve all the problem? See, today maybe for example today you are you today you are interested to eat maybe idli for our breakfast. You think about eating idli for your breakfast, but you are not provided with the option of idli. So what you need to do is you have your mindset that definitely you should take idli. So what you can do is you can search for some hotels or some mess in which they are serving idli, and you can go and eat idli. So this is a problem that you are facing. Say for example, it is a colloquial example. So your problem is you are not provided with idli in your home, but you are interested to eat idli. So what you do is you try to find a solution for that problem. What do you find is you search for some other hotels or mess in which you will be served with a delicious idli with the hot sambar. So you are searching for the suitable hotel or mess convenient to you, and you take up the food according to your expectation and convenience. Now the problem is solved, right? So what is the problem? Eating idli today for as a breakfast today. Now how we the problem is solved? So if the problem is solved, why that problem comes? Because that food is not available in your home now. So you there occurs a problem. And how do you solve that problem? You search for some hotel and you take up the idli. So if that problem is solved by computer, so I told that the computer is originally meant for solving certain numerical based problems. Not all kinds of real world problems, but numerical. So because it is originally meant for solving numerical computation. So wherever it requires a numerical computation, it comes into picture and it comes to solve the problem. So, but what is the thing that is noted down here is nowadays the computers are being treated as a machine which has some intelligence in it. You may heard about something called recommendation system, which recommends you some smart system, which tells you so what you should eat and what you should not eat, because everything is now data analytics. So based on the data analytics, maybe you have been connected with some wireless gadgets or some sensors, which will be always reading your medical parameters. And now if you want to eat idli, but your computer, and you can say that whether you can get confirmation from the machine that is you are connected with, whether I can eat idli or not. I am interested to eat idli, whether you can eat idli or not. So that machine will read your parameters like glucose, carbohydrates, protein, and other parameters, blood levels, sugar level, and other parameters in your body. And it will suggest, no, your carbohydrate is this much, your oxygen content is this much, your blood sugar. So this is not a good advice to take idli now. Better you can take oats. So if that is the thing, So what is that? Even computer can also be a one which is suggesting solution to your problem by providing some alternatives. By providing some alternatives. So even though you are not you are adamant in your home because you need only Italy, you and your parent or your responsible person who is there for you to cook food, they said that no, today that dish is not available. You have to take this. Maybe you are not convinced with. But now what the computer now is telling, the computer or the machine which is telling in a smart way, in an intelligent way, that your sugar level is this, your carbohydrate level is this, your protein level is this. So if you eat this one, then it will shoot up like this. If you shoot up like this, then you may end up with this kind of problem. So it is better not to taste such kind of food. And I can suggest you these three foods, oats or something like cereals or pulses, or something like a sprout, like that, it will suggest. So you will get convinced. Oh, okay, my body parameters is like that. The computer is telling based on the sensor reading. So I have to take up according to the advice of the computer. So this problem's solution can also be possible. So originally the author is written in that book, what kinds of problems are solved by algorithm. So he said that any problem which needs some computation, because compute is the word which gives the meaning to the machine computer, right? So, but they have some practical examples also, like a human genome project and any other internet related problems. So there is, even though there, so even though the author during the initial period of the thing, he has written something about the book, but when you are talking about the real thing, at present, the computer has entered into a many field, and it is you cannot imagine whether this problem is solved by computer, whether this is really worth for the computer to solve. You cannot imagine. So that much I think the computer is able to solve. So you cannot define a definite boundary. So only this much level the computer can solve. So you have to think beyond the boundary and beyond the limit and beyond the capacity of the computer in such a way that you have to devise the procedure, that is, you have to devise an algorithm, and you can develop an intelligent smart system, so whatever it may be. So you cannot define or you cannot confine your computer to a certain type of problem. So if you could go through this, you can find what are the other problems that is solved. So in order to solve the problem, it should be mathematically represented. That is most important. See, this is the problem. So that is, you are provided with the two sequences. Say, for example, it is a human genome project. Yeah, genome of one person may have some similarity with the genome of other person. Say, for example, a person whose eye is brownish in color. Whose eye is brownish color, and if you consider a similar person whose eye is brownish color, you can read the chromosome of both the person. If both of the person's chromosome sequence looks alike, then you may say that this is the chromosome that is highly responsible for the person eye, which is brown in color, like that. So that is called a human genome project, not only for the physical appearance of a person with respect to eye, but for the general disease cause also. Say, for example, nowadays there are many societal diseases are spreading all over. So the societal diseases are meant to the human being based on their lifestyle. So if their lifestyle is too different, then they may face a different kind of diseases. So you can study. If you have this lifestyle, definitely you will be suffering from this kind of diseases like that. So for which, what you need to understand is, you need to understand the gene level reading of the human being. So based on the gene level, that is called genetic therapy. Genetic therapy. So based on the gene level reading, you can come to a point that, okay, these two sequences are looks alike, so that may be the possibility, and this might be the reason for such kind of diseases, and you need to avoid such kind of activities hereafter, and you have to change your lifestyle so that you can do it according to your like this, right? So I think we have come up to 20 minutes session. I want to take a little break. We will close the session today, and we will see in the subsequent classes, right? Why I am starting the classes is I was